जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू टॉपिक। बिफोर आई टेल यू आवर टुडेज टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एंड नो अबाउट इट, लेट मी जस्ट आस्क यू चिल्ड्रन द नेम्स विद विच यू आर कॉल्ड at home, or when you are called in school by your school teachers, are they same? Like, we all have a good name as well as pet names, isn't so? Yes, children, we all have a good name as well as the pet names. So the good names are generally big, right? And they are used professionally, officially, right? But when we are at home, our parents, our grandparents, they call us lovingly by our pet name, right? So generally you will see, children, the pet names are quite small. They are very small, and they are used to call immediately, so that the big names can be abbreviated into a short form and can be called as immediately, isn't so? Right? So today, children, we are going to know about such nicknames or such pet names that are there in grammar, right? See, even the grammar also follows the nickname procedure or the short form procedure. So our today's topic to know about is the short forms, right, children? So today we are going to know about the short forms, or they are also called as contractions in grammar. So for that, let me just show you my screen to you all. I have prepared a PPT. There I am going to show you, and I am going to explain you that what basically the short terms or the short forms are. It's not so, children, that this is for the first time you are going to read this, right? आपने अब तक बहुत सारे अपने लिटरेचर बुक में, जब आप प्रोज पढ़ते हैं या पोएम पढ़ते हैं, यू मस्ट हैव कम अक्रॉस ऑल दीज शॉर्ट फॉर्म वर्ड्स वेरी मच, एंड यू मस्ट बी फैमिलियर विद दीज वर्ड्स, बट देन यू डोंट नो व्हेन यू एक्चुअली हैव टू यूज इट इन अ सेंटेंस, मे बी यू डोंट नो द रियल रूल ऑफ फॉलोइंग हाउ टू राइट दैम। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मास्टराइज इन टू दिस टॉपिक। Let's then start, children. So here, let me just share the screen with you all. And here we go. So children, today, let me just take my pen. And I'm going to take, first choose a color. And I'll choose yellow color. So today, children, we are going to know about short forms. Okay, short forms. And what are short forms? The words that are used in grammar, especially in grammar, children. I'm talking about grammar. In English grammar, we have full forms, and at the same time we just shorten up some words. They are called short forms. Well, short forms are also called as contractions. Okay, so don't get confused if you see contractions, children, because contractions and short forms, they are both the one and the same, right, children? So short forms are also called as contractions. Now let us know what are contractions, children. So here it is. See, read it out, children. Now you have to listen to me very, very carefully. If you attentively listen to me, you will masterize in this, children. You will learn this, how to use the contractions in grammar or in the sentence, right, children? So let us know what is a contraction. Can you just read out the sentence, children? A contraction is two words put together to make one word. Now make sure, children, that you don't miss these words. Two words to make into one word, right, children? So what is a contraction? Contraction is nothing but to join two words together to make one word, right? So like, if I show you this example, let me just take some other color because it's not visible. Yeah, so if I take this example of is not, so here you can see this is the full form we generally write in a sentence, like this is not mine or this is not my ball, right? We write like this, right? So this is the full form, this is not. And when we contract this word or when we shorten this word, it gets transferred into like this, that is isn't. Right, we call it isn't. It, this isn't my ball or this isn't my bag, right? So what is the difference that you can see, children? See, this is the difference. Don't forget the apostrophe. Yes, so the difference that you will see is that one of the letter of not is omitted, right? Not O letter is omitted, and in place of O, what is there? In place of O, the letter which has been omitted, in that place we have put an apostrophe, right? So this is how we contract the words. So that, what is the use of contracting the words? So that you could, you know, we can speak up fast. If we have to say this is not my ball, so it takes a little more time as compared to if I say this isn't my ball, right? So I can say speak fast if I shorten up the words, right? So this is the only use of shortening the words, because we can speak little fast, right? So this is the way you can shorten it. Now let's know more that what are the rules or how to apply the contraction rules so that we can also contract the words, right? So let us know the rules one by one. Very, very important points, children. You have to read them very nicely and always remember these 4 points. These 4 points are very, very important points. If you remember them, then you will never have problem in understanding contraction. So the very, very important points are, the first point is, let me just explain this to you. The first point is, a contraction is one word made from two words, right, children? Always remember this, that a contraction is a one word, right? It is one word itself that is made up of two words. Like as I showed you the previous example, isn't is made up of two words, that is plus not, right? Is plus not, that is, there are two words, and when we join them together, it becomes single word, that is isn't, right? So this is the first important point. The second important point is, the first word usually stays the same, right, children? Now you will always see, just a second, let me just rub this. So children, you will always see that generally in any contracted word, when the word is contracted, you will see the first word remains unchanged. Okay, usko hum touch nahi karte, we don't omit any letter from the first word, right? In fact, let's read down the third point. The certain letters are taken out of the second word, right, children? In fact, the second word, in that second word, we take out or we omit some of the letters, right? We omit some of the letters. Like in this case, is not, we have omitted which letter, can you tell me? We omitted the letter O, right? We omitted the letter O. Now, what will happen after omitting the letter O? What is the next thing that we are supposed to do? An apostrophe will fill the space of the missing letters, right, children? And apostrophe will fill the space of the missing letter. So wherever the word, the letter is missed, we are going to put what? We are going to put the apostrophe. So what does apostrophe actually denotes? That apostrophe tells us that a word, that a letter is omitted or is missed from here, from this place, right? So aapko char cheezon ka dhyan dena hai. Pehli cheez beta, ki कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड वर्ड्स हमेशा दो वर्ड को मिलाकर बनते हैं. सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड वर्ड में हम पहले वर्ड को इज, जैसे कि इज नॉट, सो हम पहले वर्ड को टच नहीं करते. वी डोंट ओमिट एनी लेटर फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट वर्ड जनरली. एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट वॉट एवर चेंजेस आर डन, इट्स डन इन द सेकेंड वर्ड. So we omit some of the letters from the second word, and in that place, in the omitted letters, in the place of omitted letters, apostrophe takes that place. Okay. So what does apostrophe means? Apostrophe means samajh jana hai jahan apostrophe laga. It means that a letter is omitted from that place, right, children? So this is the rule that you have to understand, right? Now. Hope that you have understood this, children. So let me now just show you some examples of present tense verbs, right? Like is, am, are. So how we are going to know this, children? See, there is a subject, like the pronoun words you can see here in one of the column, like I, you, he, she, it, we, you, we, they, right? And the verb is there in the other side. So this is, we will consider this block as the first word. This is the first word, okay? This is the first word, and this one is the second word. Whenever we are making a contraction, all, as I told you, there will be two words, okay? You will always find there are two words. Like in this case, let's first take the example. So the first word is I and the second word is am. So, as I said, as per the rule, the first word is never ever omitted. We omit the letters from the second word. So, what is the contracted word? Can you tell me? This is the contracted word or the short form. So, how we contracted? I and am becomes am, right? Am, right? Listen to my pronunciation, children. Am. I am a boy. Instead of that, I can say I'm a boy. I'm a boy. I'm, right? So here you can see a letter A is omitted, and in that place apostrophe comes, that takes the place, right? At the place, the letter where we have omitted it, the apostrophe takes its place. You are becomes you are, right? You are. So you are becomes you are. Right, here again letter A is omitted and apostrophe takes its place, right? He is becomes he's, she is becomes she's, it is becomes its, right? You are becomes your, we are becomes we are, they are becomes their, right? So this is how you have to contract it, and you actually have to learn them. You must have come across all such words. You already have seen them in your literature book while reading the stories, right? Now you know the rule that how it is contracted. Now let me just show you some examples with the help of these sentences, how to use them, children, okay? So here, see, I will first show you a full sentence with the full form. Like, see, I am waiting for my friends. This one. I am waiting for my friends. So here the full form, like I am, is used. I am waiting for my friends. Now the second example shows how to contract it. This is contracted form. That is, I'm waiting for my friends. So here you can see letter A is omitted and apostrophe takes the place of A. Right? So, I'm waiting for my friends. The same way, children, it is a beautiful day. So, instead of that, when we contract the word, that is, it is. So, we are going to say, it's a beautiful day. It is a beautiful day becomes, it's a beautiful day. Now, can you see, children, how I am pronouncing these two sentences? When I say the first sentence, I say it is a beautiful day, and when I say the second sentence, I say it's a beautiful day, right? So this is what you have to learn. Now let me just show you some of the contracted words with the will, in the will form, right? Like, see, I will becomes I'll, right? You will becomes you'll. Now recently you have read the poem Two Little Kittens. So there this word was there. You'll take the mice. We will see that, right? So you have come across this word in the poem Two Little Kittens, right? You will becomes you'll. He will becomes he'll. She will become she'll. They will they'll. We will we'll. It will it'll. Right? So here you can see, children, the first word in all the words you will see, the first word remains untouched. We don't change the or omit any letter from the first word, right? In the second word, what we do, we omit letter W when we are writing will, okay? When there is will in the second word, so in this, what is the rule? You have to omit W and omit W and I, not only W, W and I, and in place of W and I, what will come at that place? We will use the apostrophe. So apostrophe means that some letters are omitted from this place, right? So and it becomes I'll, right? So now let's see some example, children. Let me just show you one example. Like, see, we will go to a picnic next Sunday. So when we shorten it, it becomes we'll go to a picnic next Sunday. We will go to a picnic next Sunday becomes we'll go to the picnic next Sunday, right? Now let me just show you some contractions or some contracted words with not form, right? In a negative form. When we use the words not at the end, then how we are going to write it down? Like are not becomes aren't. Cannot. This already I have taught you, children, when in the grammar, when we have read about cannot, can, cannot, should not. So in that you have already got to know the short form of cannot. I told you cannot becomes can't. Do not becomes don't. Have not becomes haven't. Is not becomes isn't. Should not becomes shouldn't. Was not becomes wasn't. Will not becomes won't. Right? Now you may say, children, that ma'am, will not ko won't kyun bana diya hai? It should be willn't. Right? But children, let me tell you the short form or the contracted form of will not cannot be written as willn't. If we write will, just a second, let me just write it. If we write willn't, if we write the short form of will not as willn't, this is wrong, right? Why, children? Because in ancient time, not now, ye English hai. See, always there in English, there is always, you will find different rule is applied everywhere. So, in this case also, you will find a different rule. The rule is that there, in ancient times, not now, before, in German, will not was said as would not, right? वहाँ पर उसको won't not कहा जाता था. So इसीलिए won't not की इस तरह से बन गया, won't not. तो वहाँ पर will जैसा कोई शब्द नहीं use होता था, वहाँ पे won't किया जाता था, won't not बोलते थे. So that's why when the short form of won't not becomes won't, right? So we use the term of will not, the contraction form is won't. Remember this, children. ये आपको learn करना होगा, ये एकदम ध्यान में रखना होगा. Will not का form आपको short form won't होगा, right? Would not becomes wouldn't. So in not, when you find the not cases, what you are supposed to do? Not में o omit होगा and you, that, in that place apostrophe will take that place. Okay? Very simple. Now let me show you an example in a sentence form. Do not make a noise in the class. So in that case, the contracted form would be don't make a noise in the class. So when if we say do not make a noise in the class, that's in the full form. And if we say it in a short form, we say don't make a noise in the class. Right, children? So hope, children, now you have understood the concept well. So let us now do the book exercise from page number 67, that is there in your English grammar book, short forms. So let's read it out. Sometimes we squeeze a word to make it shorter. Example, instead of do not, we write don't. These words are called contractions, as I told you, or short forms. Don't is a contraction. Notice we have put an apostrophe on the top after the N, and not is used there, O. An apostrophe is used in place of the missing letter. So often we also write she is as she's, and we are as we are, I am as am, right? So here we remove the I and A and use the apostrophe instead. So look at the table, children. This table, if you remember this table, children, agar aap isko acche se dhyan mein rakh lenge, it will be easy for you. He is, as I showed you, I have already shown you the table. One more table with the not form. Already I have shown you this too, right? Now let us do exercise 1. So when we practice it, children, when we start doing it, then we get better into it. So let's start with exercise 1. Write contractions for the following words. One has been done for you. Like, see, have not ko hum kya likhenge? Haven't. Maine kya bataya tha? Not mein hamesha O ko omit karna hai and uske jagah apostrophe lagana hai. They are. So what is the rule to apply? Use the shorter form or the contracted form? They are. So we are not going to touch the first word, children. R ko hume change karna hai. R ka kya part hum omit karenge? Which letter? We will omit the letter A, right? And it becomes they are. So we will use they and then apostrophe and re, they are. It is becomes it's, right? I will be omitted, right? You are becomes A is omitted and in that place an apostrophe will take its place. So you are. Would not, again not mein aapko omit karna hai and it becomes wouldn't. I will. So here मैंने आपको बताया है, याद करो बेटा, मैंने ये भी आपको दिखाया था, आई विल. तो मैंने क्या बताया था रूल विल के लिए? वेन यू फाइंड दिस वर्ड विल इन द सेकेंड वर्ड, यू विल ओमिट टू लेटर्स, दैट इज डब्ल्यू एंड आई, राइट? डब्ल्यू एंड आई विल बी ओमिटेड एंड उसकी जगह वन, यू हैव टू यूज जस्ट वन एपोस्ट्रॉफी एंड डबल एल. सो आई विल, राइट? शुड नॉट, यू ओमिट ओ एंड इट बिकम्स शुडन्ट. Did not omit letter O and it becomes didn't, right? Now let's see exercise 2. Write the following sentences using the short forms of is, are and not. One has been done for you. Do not talk, so don't talk. She is a smart girl but she cannot cook. So how to do that? How to do that, children? She is. So she is ko pehle short karo. She's a smart girl but she cannot cook. Short kaise karenge? Can't cook, right? So this is the answer. She is a smart girl but she can't cook. Number C, the teacher tells us that we are a good class. So the teacher tells us that we are. So hum isko short karenge, we are. So how to do that? The teacher tells us that we are a good class, right? You should not talk rudely. So how to shorten it? Should not ko hum short kaise karte hain? Shouldn't, right? You shouldn't talk rudely. We are going to meet my grandparents. So what we are going to do? We are. How to shorten it? We are. We are going to meet my grandparents. So this is how you have to learn using the contracted form. I hope that this is quite easy, super easy, children. So now children, next thing that I want to show you, that is just to recap the things. Okay, I'm going to recap all the things that we have just read and learned in this topic. So what we have learned here, children, when we are using the form of contractions or when we are using the contraction words. So the first rule says, the first word says the stays the same. Remember, children, the first rule is that the first word remains the same. Now what is the second rule, children? Tell me, what is the second rule? The second word pops out letters. Second word se kuch letter पॉप आउट हो जाते हैं, निकल जाते हैं, ओमिट हो जाते हैं, मिस हो जाते हैं. सो द सेकेंड वर्ड पॉप्स आउट द लेटर्स. And very important, when the letters are popped out from the second word, what do we use in place of them? An apostrophe holds their spot. Apostrophe unke jagah pe aa jata hai, right? Remember this children, yaad rakhenge, first word hamesha same rahega, second word se hum letter omit karenge aur uske jagah pe apostrophe add karenge. Very simple. So hope children that this topic is now quite clear to all of you, and I'm sure that I think so that you will not have any doubt related to this, right children? So complete the book exercise. Along with the book exercise children, I have given one notebook exercise too. Okay, I am going to give you a notebook exercise that you will do as a homework, as a practice in your English B notebook, where you are supposed to do in your English B notebook. So let me just show this to you, where you have to do this children. This is your notebook work. This I am going to upload it in the e-learning. You will get this homework, and what you're supposed to do, match with the correct short form. So here you will find the full forms one side, on the other side there are contracted forms. So you have to match the full form with the correct short form. Okay children, so this is the homework for you. Okay, I am going to upload this and you will complete your homework. Okay children, so that's it for today. Soon we will meet again and we will start a new topic. Till then, take care of yourself and have a nice day.